So, good morning to all the learners who are here today for this induction meeting. Dear learners, as you all know that you have taken admission for July 2020 session. In IGNU, the very first step for starting of your studies and your all your activities is induction meeting. During this induction meeting, you all will be able to know about the activities you all have to perform during your program. Today we have called the induction meeting for the learners of Master of Arts in History, that is MA History, MA in Development Studies, and MA in Rural Development. So here today we all have learners for these three programs. The admission process had started long back in the month of May, June. However, as the UGC kept on extending the dates, the induction meeting could not be organized for you learners. But we believe that many of you might have received the books as well. Today, we are organizing this induction meeting and a lot of details will be provided to you. You all can note down the important details. The video is being recorded as well. You all will receive the recorded session of this, video of this session as well. We have our regional director, Dr. E. Krishna Rao sir, with us. He will first guide the learners, then we will have small PPT presentation, and after that, individual queries will also be taken. One by one, whoever has any query will be taken by the regional center. With this, I first of all request our regional director, sir, to please guide the learners. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Good morning to all the learners. At outset, I wish you a happy new year and happy Makar Sankranti also. At outset, I congratulate you all for registering for different programs. Today we have called master degree programs, but of course the process has started. Everyone knows, as per the Government of India guidelines, the dates have been extended. However, Indira Gandhi National Open University Regional Center Mumbai has taken care about the students, those who have taken the admission earlier. Since these programs are having the less enrollment number, we have connected about 12 induction meetings so far. So far, July 2020 admissions under the Regional Center of Mumbai, about 6,000 students have registered for the different programs. Whatever the programs are having the highest enrollment number, for them, we have already conducted the induction meeting. Because of the students may be under the pressure, under the tension, maybe when that course is going to be start, because of it was started from the July, I say, okay, the admissions have started. However, your program is yearly based program. Your program is yearly based program. You all have joined for the July 2020 academic cycle. It is July 2020 academic cycle. And you all have to understand, Indira Gandhi National Open University is a central university. It is under the directly under the Ministry of Education. Directly under the Ministry of Education. Okay, it is only the National Open University. And your program, whatever you have joined, MA History or MA Development Studies or other program, master degree program, you all have joined for the July 2020, and your examinations will be conducted in this year, June 2021. In between this period, we will provide you student support services, where we used to conduct online academic counseling sessions. That is also very limited online academic counseling sessions. and you have to write your assignments, you have to go through your study material, and you have to approach your academic counselors through online for clearing of your doubts. You have to write your examination in the June 2021. For that, you have to submit the assignments by April 2021. But maybe you think the duration is very less. We are having the time. Once you have taken the admission itself, once your admission is confirmed, your activity has started. Don't wait for the, that is the thing you have to understand. No need to wait till someone asks you to read, someone will ask you to write. The every information is given in our website. And the program guide is also available. Really, it is in the public domain. This all open distance learning it is. If it is a conventional mode of the education where they will tell you everything, the teacher will come every day and they will take the classes line to line, paragraph wise explanation, there is a unit test and all. But here it is a open distance learning. It is adult education. You are all matured learners. You are all having the knowledge already. You have joined here to add value to your existing knowledge. And some of them are joined here to get the additional degree and get benefit in their employment. Maybe someone has joined with the passion to acquire the knowledge. Someone has joined simply to know the things, to know more about the particular subject. That is all happening. Okay, you all have joined with the different objectives, and you have to understand this is the open and distance learning where it is the adult population ke liye. This open distance learning system has been established by the government of India. IGNO was established in 1985 by the Parliament Act. From that 187 onwards, IGNO is offering so many programs, certificate, diploma, bachelor's, master's, and other skill-based program. Here you have to understand, in the open distance learning, because if I am seeing the faces of well-experienced people, not the young, not only this is the, because of in the open distance learning, you are having the heterogeneous group. It is not homogeneous group. If you see the in the conventional mode, where the age-wise, knowledge-wise, experience-wise, all are homogeneous. Here you can see the different variety of the people. Some of them are the professionals. Some of them are the housewives. Some of them are the already government officers with the different knowledge, different level of the knowledge, different level of the experience. That's why you have to understand here teacher and student are separated by the physical distance. Because of you are all matured, no need to ask every point to your teacher. By going through the study material, you will be understanding in a such a beautiful way the study material has been prepared. That's why it is called as a self-learning material. It is called as a self-instructional material, self-directional material, self-evaluating material. In this open distance learning, you have to understand the first the system, how it works, what are the procedures, how the this what type of the instructional system we have adopted. That all you have to understand. Then your journey in the IGNO will be comfortable. Otherwise, all the time, if you are not understanding the system, if you are not understanding what type of the instructional method we have adopted, you will all the time will be in confused mode. Your journey will not be comfortable. That's why in the open distance learning induction meeting plays a crucial role, where in the induction meeting we will provide you all academic administrative inputs regarding your studies. You have to understand, if you see the instructional system, that is a very important one, where I'm not going, maybe you go one by one, you go to the this PPT will be shared with you, but I am not touching the points, because of wherever you need more information, only I am going to make the point on that one. Later on we will have the discussion, whatever the problems you are feeling, means where you need more clarity also, we will discuss. Now one has to understand how the program will be delivered in the IGNO. That is a very important one. In the IGNO, the program delivered by adopting the multimedia approach. If you see the multimedia approach is the consist of three important components, which are shown on the screen. You can see the three important components. First one is the study material. Here we have mentioned as a SIM. SIM means self-instructional material. SLPM also it is mentioned. That means self-learning printed material. This is the material which is a, as I told beginning, it is a self-explanatory material. It is self-contained material. It is a self-directional material. It is a self-motivating material. It is a self-evaluating material. It is a self-learning material. Further, it is a teacher inbuilt material. In the conventional mode, whenever you go to the classroom, whenever you are interacting with your teacher, you will get the feel and your doubts will be cleared. But here, through the study material, your teacher will teach you. Through your study material, you are going to discuss with your teacher. Your teacher is teaching through the study material in a such a beautiful way. The study material has been prepared, because of, if you see the structure of the study material, the structure of the study material, if you see, even if you take the Master of Arts in History, maybe in the first year, generally any program having the 3 to 5 courses, first year 3 to 5 courses, that each course is having the 3 to 5 blocks of the study material, each block divided into the units, minimum 3 to maximum 6-7 units tak ye hota hai. Units again divided into the sections, sections again divided into the subsections. This is the structure of the study material. If you see the unit structure, that is the beauty of the study material, where in the conventional mode, whatever the textbook you are having, the total textbook is having only one objective. But whereas here, each unit is having its own objective. Its own objective. If you see the structure, where the introduction, objectives of particular unit, then again the sections, that is the main theme. Theme again, sub-theme, that is the subsections. And the, finally, if you see the point number 4, summary of the each unit given in the end. And the next one is the unit end activities. There are some questions they have given. You have to do the some activities, and the questions also they have given, and even suggested readings and other books also you can, they have suggested. Final one is 8 point, is the very important one, answer to check your progress. That's why we have highlighted in the yellow color, check your progress. That is a very important one. Every unit, end of the unit, you have to do the check your progress activity. That's why this study material is called as a self-evaluating study material. One thing I am telling here, no one is going to teach you line by line. As I told in the beginning, you are the adult, you are all well experienced and having the knowledge. You have to understand yourself. By doing these activities, you will be understanding the study material. But maybe you are thinking, you are new to the system where study material also first time you are reading. Maybe you are thinking, how I have to read the study material? That is also one of the doubt you are having. Maybe that is also difficult for the newly joined students. Here, we are giving you some suggestions. If you follow that suggestions, your reading of the study material will be very comfortable. Once you open the book, once you open the unit, first you read the objectives thoroughly. You understand the objectives, whatever has given. Once you understand the study with these objectives, then go slowly to the main theme. Without reading the objectives, understanding the objectives, because of the in the objectives they have given very clearly what they are going to teach in this unit, then only you have to go to the main content. While going through the study material, if you find some diagrams, some important events, even MA history, there are so many historical events that all you have to give the due importance to that one. And any diagrams they have given, any data they have given, that you have to understand. While going through the study material, you have to prepare your own notes. You have to prepare your own notes. And also, wherever you get the doubts, suppose some concepts are not clear, you make note of that concepts, which will be cleared later in your academic counseling sessions. That is a very important one. Here, we are giving the option, two type of the options. One is students can opt the hard copy, or you can opt for the soft copy. The students, those who opted the soft copy, they got the 15% of fee concession. 15% of the fee concession. Such type of the students will not get any hard copy. You have to read the soft copy, which is available in public domain. That is the egyankosh.ac.in. Go to the next slide. There is a link already we have given in your this one. Study material is available in the soft copy, egyankosh.ac.in. What my humble request to all the students, though you have a hard copy, that hard copy will be sent by the Material Production and Distribution Division, IGNO New Delhi, directly to your postal address. The status also, they're updating in our website, igno.ac.in. However, what I suggest to you, maybe by end of this month, all the students will get the study material. There is no issue of that one. They have already started sending the material. Some of the students might have received. Some of them material status is under the process. All the students, mostly maximum, by end of this month, you will receive directly from the Delhi to your postal address. Whatever the address you have given, you'll get. Meanwhile, because of we are all well equipped, acquainted with the technology, where everyone is having the smartphones or the laptops, maybe you are all the working professions. What you have to do till you get the hard copy, please read the soft copy. Please read the soft copy, and you can download. IGNO has developed a digitalized study material, which is synchronized and also edited, and the simple format may it is available in the e-content app. If you type in the Google Play Store, IGNO e-content app, that is a mobile app, you can download to your mobile. Whenever you are traveling, you can read. Now I have seen one student is traveling. Even though he is traveling, he is just listening what the regional director is telling in this induction meeting. That type of the facility everyone is having. Please make use of that facility and read that soft copy of the study material. And other important one is the study material ke baad you are having the counseling sessions, academic counseling sessions. Academic counseling session is the face to face interaction between the academic counselor. I am telling here we are not calling them as a teachers, we are calling them as the academic counselors. In the open distance learning, it is the mixing of the tutoring and the guidance, both involved in the counseling. That's why we used to call it as a academic counseling sessions. Pre-COVID-19, we used to organize physical counseling sessions where student has to go to the study center, that is Saturday or Sundays. Because of you are all working people, maximum classes will be conducted on Sundays, sometimes Saturdays also, on the basis of the student request. We used to conduct mostly we conduct on the Sundays. The counseling schedule we used to send to the students, study center will send to the students, and it will upload in our IGNO website and share in the Facebook page and the Twitter. And all the things we used to do, we will send an email to the students. The counseling session, student has to travel to the study center. But now during the COVID-19 time, on the basis of the situation, we have switched on to this online counseling sessions. Now I think maybe up to the 6 months, we are not going to call the students to the study center. We organize only the online counseling sessions. Once this induction meeting is over, maybe in the next month onwards, we will start the counseling sessions through online. That is all very limited counseling sessions. Very limited. That's what I told while going through the study material. Whatever the doubts you are having, you have to note down. You have to note down. Only discussion method they adopt in the classroom. There is no lecture method. Don't expect any type of the teaching. Before attending the counseling sessions, whether it is the offline or online, the student should go through the study material, the soft copy or the hard copy. You have to go through. You have to prepare your own notes. And you have to make the points to be discussed in the counseling sessions. Counseling session should be live. It should not be one-way communication. It is a two-way communication where you are raising the questions, where you are asking the concepts for more clarity. Academic counselor used to give more clarity on the particular topic. That is the two-way communication. You have to ask and they will give the reply, and it should be live. The session, the method what they adopted is the discussion method, interaction method. There is no lecture method in the academic counseling sessions. That's why you all have to remember, before going to the counseling session, you have to go through the study material. And this counseling session is not compulsory. This counseling session is not compulsory. If you are comfortable, if you are having the time, you can attend. Otherwise, you can go through the study material, you can prepare, and you can write the examinations. That is the thing in the counseling session. Okay, this in addition to face-to-face counseling sessions, either through the online, maybe Facebook or Google Meet, we used to organize. In addition to that, during this COVID time, what we have done, our school faculty, from the Delhi, they used to conduct the live sessions in the Facebook. In the Facebook live sessions, they used to organize. They used to organize. And also our Honorable Vice Chancellor taken the decision, that is a very good decision, where there is no barriers to attend the counseling sessions in the online platform. As you know, under the regional IGNO, there are total 56 regional centers. All the 56 regional centers, counseling schedule compiled and post in the Facebook page. Any student, even the Mumbai student, can attend the Delhi counseling sessions if it is relevant to you. Delhi student can attend the Calcutta counseling sessions. Calcutta student can attend the Hyderabad sessions. There is no barriers. Whatever the time is convenient to you, you can see the schedule, accordingly you can attend. That is our Honorable Vice Chancellor has directed all the regional centers to post the counseling sessions in the our IGNO Facebook page. As per our Honorable Vice Chancellor directions, last session, we have compiled and posted in the Facebook page. You have to remember two Facebook pages, my dear learners. One is our IGNO headquarters Facebook page, IGNO Facebook page, and the second one is Regional Center Mumbai Facebook page, IGNO RC Mumbai Facebook page. If you like and if you follow, you will get all notifications. You will get all notification related to the counseling sessions, already recorded versions, is all the notification you receive. Because of nowadays social media, we are using exclusively and we are posting all the important information. Then please like the page and you will get all the notifications. In addition to the face-to-face counseling, Facebook counseling, and we are having GD2, that is the Gyan Darshan 2, that is the 24 hours educational channel. It is IGNO educational channel. Gyan Darshan 2, sitting at your home, it is a free in all the dish. It is a government channel, that is IGNO channel, 24 hours. The schedule also uploads every month in our IGNO website. You can see it. Suppose MA history counseling sessions are there, MA development studies is there, another MA English or the MA economics, whatever the counseling sessions are there, you can see it. That is a 24 hours educational channel. In addition to that, IGNO is having Gyandhara, that is online radio. Online radio, that is the Gyandhara. Through that also, we used to counsel, we used to take the sessions for the students. This is all audio video facilities available. You all have to please follow that one. One thing I am telling, why I made the point in the beginning itself, induction meeting is very important one. Because of this information we provide in the induction meeting. If you are not attending the induction meeting, this information you are not knowing. You all the time you are waiting. The regional center will send the counseling schedule, or they will send the mail to attend the counseling, or they will send when to submit the assignments and when to write the examination like that. No, we will not send any communication. All the information uploads in our IGNO website and our regional center website and our Facebook page, Twitter. You have to follow that one. You have to go through the information accordingly. You have to submit the required things in the time. If you miss the timing, you have to pay for that. Means your session will be late. That is the thing I mean to say. That is the counseling sessions. As we have seen, we are having the study material. We are having the audio video. Counseling sessions, and we are having the other counseling. Okay, these are the instructional system in the ignore. Audio video is also available one side. Another one is the face-to-face counseling also available. That you have to understand this one accordingly. You have to make use of the facilities. Then the three using the three methods, we provide you the studies. And now you will be evaluated. The thing is, you have taken admission. You have been provided the support services, academic support service. We supply the study material to the online or the offline. We will conduct the counseling sessions and audio video packages we give. Is all over. Then how the student will be evaluated? We adopted the continuous evaluation. Student continuously evaluated. Not only in the one point, continuously evaluated. In the every unit we have seen self-assessment, check your progress. Then the next step is assignments. Student has to write one assignment for one course, which is very compulsory one. And the third step is the term end examinations. And the another type of the evaluation is the through the project or the workshop or the internship, student evaluated. This is the all the continuous evaluation where we can call multi-tier system of the evaluation. Self-assessment ke liye, there is no marks. Yourself, you are assessing. Where coming to the assignments. Assignment carries 30% of the weightage. Term and examinations carries 70% of the weightage. One thing, my dear learners, you all have to remember. Each course ke liye, one course is having the one assignment. Assignment writing is compulsory one. Without writing the assignments, you are not permitted for the term and examinations. Then may be thinking, how we can write the assignments? And where we have to submit the assignment? Where we will get the assignment questions? That all maybe students are having. But here, first you have to understand. One thing is, assignment is the compulsory component to write the examination. And the second one is, one course ke liye, each course you have to write one assignment. Third point is, assignment carries 30% of the weightage. These three are the important ones. Now we will go through the assignments. How to write the assignments? Maybe you are new to the system. Assignment questions, we upload in the website. If you go to the IGNO website, igno.ac.in, under the downloads, the assignments is there. We will show you that also. Even the live also we will show, but however in the PPT the links also there. And the in the assignment to get the good marks, you have to give the correct information. You have to write, and also this assignments should be a limited papers. If they ask to write the 500 words, you write maximum 600. Don't write the 5000 words. It is wasting of your energy. It is wasting of the paper and the time also. Whatever the word limit they have given, maybe 100 you can write jada, and also don't copy. Don't reproduce. If you reproduce, the academic counselor knows from where you got the information, whether it is copied or written in own words. The student who write the assignment in their own words will get the more marks. The student who copies who reproduce the information in the study material same, they may not get the good marks or may not get the pass mark also. That's why you have to understand the content and write in your own words. And the while that assignments are handwritten, no typed assignments will accept. Assignment should be handwritten. Some of the students are asking, sir, how on what type of paper, any specific paper is there? There is no specific paper. You can use the A4 or A3 or ruled paper or the white paper, but don't use the color paper. And some of them are asking, sir, I have to use the black pen or the blue pen. You know, you are all well matured. You can use the either black or the blue, not the red and green. You are not supposed to use that one. Maybe you can use the sketch pens also to highlight. And to, if you want to say something to the academic counselor, which is the important one, you can highlight. And the assignment should have the correct information, logical sequence, how you are narrating, how you are presenting the assignment, it should have the logical sequence. And also clarity of the expression is a very important one. The language, what you are using, how you are writing, that is also a very important one. And also legibility is very important. Since you are writing, the assignments are handwritten, someone is writing. After writing of the assignments, if you ask the student to read, they may also not be in a position to read. Such type of the handwriting someone is having. I'm not making the point, but while writing the assignment, you should be very careful about your handwriting. It should be legible, and also someone should read. Once the academic counselor read only, they will give the marks. If your writing is not legible, and how they will give the marks, that you have to take into the note while writing the assignments. As I told, don't copy, don't reproduce, understand the content, use your own words and write and submit. Then if you see the assignments download link is in the next slide, you can see, you can download from the this webservices.igno.ac.in, and our staff will show you the how to download and the live also. This one, once you click that one, here it is given MA history. You can see MA development studies or MA rural development. You can see, and the current year assignments, you all have joined for the July 2020. In the assignment, they write these assignments are for the July 2020 and January 2021. Such type of the assignments only you have to take. Your session should be there. That is the July 2020 is your session. You can download the assignment questions and you can start writing the assignments. Your assignment submission date is in the month of the April 2021. April 2021, April or the May. Since you got delayed, we will give time up to the May. Your examinations in the June 2021, that you have to understand. Before that, you have to submit the assignments if you are willing to write the your examination. Then in the evaluation May, another component is the term and examination. Theory ke liye examination conducts twice in a year. We used to conduct the examination twice in a year. That is June and the December. As I told, you are all going to have examination in the June 2021. Suppose if you are not comfortable writing the examination in the June 2021 first year, you can write it December 2021. There is no force, there is no compulsion to write your first year examination only in the June 2021. If you need the time, you can extend it and you can write December 2021. Suppose if you want to write the examination in the June 2021, in the April month you have to fill the online examination form. That is, link is given, exam.igno.ac.in. Payment also through online. It is 150 rupees per page, this one course. And the hall ticket also you can download, from our website. That is all, everything. No need to ask anyone also. This hall ticket ke liye. And the hall ticket will upload. You can do that one. And you can select any examination center. Maybe suppose the flexibility what we are having. Suppose you are a Mumbai person. Next to June 2021, maybe you are flying or traveling to the Delhi. You will not be available in the Mumbai. You can select the examination center in the Delhi. No need to postpone your exam. You can write the examination in the Delhi. There is no problem. You can select examination center across the country. Though you are belongs to RC Mumbai, you can write exam across the country. But while filling the online examination form, you have to select the examination center where you are going to write the examination. That is the very important one. This is the link for the previous year question papers. You all can download that. You can see it. And the next important one is, this is not required to them. Permanent practical examination is not required. And another important one is, in your case, one more important thing you have to. These are all the things available where we used to declare the result within the 45 days. After the last examination, we used to upload your result, and also this is, if you are not satisfied with the result, you can go for the re-evaluation also. Even you can get your answer script also, photocopy. For that you all have to do that one. You can, there are the, because of, since it is a government institution, it is a central university, we are having all such type of the facilities. And just about the provisions, you are all having the rights. There is no issue of that one. And the coming to the important issue is the re-registration. Maybe you are confused sometimes. What is this re-registration? Re-registration is nothing but the second year registration. Because of this is open distance learning, where the students, these learners, are mostly working professionals. Maybe they are not having the time also. Sometimes that's why we have given the flexibility. You all have joined the master degree. Your minimum period is 2 years, maximum period is 4 years. With the 4 years, you all have to complete the program. That is the mandate. Otherwise, you are losing the 4 years. Okay, that is a thing. First year, now you have taken the admission. This is the first year you have registered. Second year ke liye you have to do the re-registration in the July 2021 session. This year, July 2021 session ke liye, re-registration process will start in the month of the May or the June. It will start. That is the second year registration. If you are comfortable to join the second year in the month of the June or the July 2021, you can do the re-registration. Suppose if you feel, just now only I have joined, maybe I am having the hectic schedule in my employment, I may not spend the much time, you can go for the January 2022 cycle also. Maybe your study period will be extended 6 more months. Okay, now second year ke liye you have to do the re-registration. That is starting in the month of the May or June this year, 2021. That is, this re-registration is also like the examination. We give the option in the July and the January. January and July, two sessions we can take the re-registration as per your comfortability. Within this 4 years time, you have to complete your program. I suggest all the students complete within the minimum period, whatever is there, the 2 years. SME of re-registration you do, later on you can write your theory examinations. Don't postpone the re-registration. Now you have joined the July 2021 second year re-registration, you do it, and maybe as per your comfortability you can complete your program. That is the thing. Okay, these are all the important issues. But now let me see the regional center. Now you are all joined under the regional center of Mumbai. What type of the support services you will get? Because of in the IGNO, we are having the three-tier system. We are having the three-tier system where the headquarters, regional center, and the study center. Study center is the important and the main contact point for the students. Grassroots level, the study center is taking care about the student support services. Of course, under the regional center Mumbai, there are some 26 study centers are there, and we are providing the support services from the 2009 onwards. We are having the such a good study centers like the AJ Somaya, Sathya College, Pillai College, Pearl Academy, Thakur College, and so on. There are 26 across the 6 districts under this regional center Mumbai. The jurisdiction is the Mumbai Suburban, Thane, Palghar, Raigad, and Ratnagiri. These are the districts under this one. And here, if you see the support services related to the program delivery, study center plays a crucial role, where in the study center level, you have to submit your assignments, you have to attend your counseling sessions, you have to attend your practicals at the study center level. Now, other support services related to your admission, your change of the course, or name correction, and the address change, or your study material related, and your radio counseling, and Gyan Darshan related schedule, and your Viva Voice, and your project. These are all the issues dealt by the regional center. And headquarters will declare your result, and they will dispatch your certificate. Here, latest development, what I am telling. Now, IGNO has gone little advanced related to the student support services through online. I think we will play the video also. Already we have uploaded in our regional center YouTube channel, IGNO RC Mumbai YouTube channel. One video that is a length of 10 minutes. Our staff has prepared about the support services. Here, whatever we have mentioned, you all have taken the admission through online. Suppose you are changing your address. Suppose you are changing your address. Maybe you are shifting your ghar, that new address. For that, no need to write any letter, no need to send any email. You can do it in online. All have taken through Samarth portal. There, you have to create new user ID, that whatever the user ID and password you are having, it is for the admission. Now, no use of that user ID and password. Now, we will show you that link also. You have to go through that one. You have to create new user ID and password. From that user ID and password, there are so many student support services. Change of address, change of regional center, name correction, and even study material related, the status, and your re-registration status, all we are making through that Samarth portal, but however it is under the maintenance. Now presently we are activated, your address change, some name correction, regional center change, study center change, these options we have activated. We will show you that one. You can make it through online. There is no need of any hard copy. That is the very important one. Here, finally, I conclude, and I will say one thing. Whatever the information I have given, it is in the program guide. The program guide is available in the soft copy. The program guide is your Bible. The program guide is your Quran. The program guide is your Bhagavad Gita, related to your studies in the IGNO. Everyone, I request, please go through the program guide related to your particular program. You will get all the information. And I am stopping here. I wish you all the best. We will take the student individual queries. Before that, our staff will show you Shashank and Abhishek. Our staff will show you our regional center website. Our regional center website. Our regional center Facebook page. And whatever the latest student support services through online. After these three components, we will take the student individual queries. Okay, I think maybe they have prepared some program specific PPT also. Since today we have called MA History, MA Rural Development, MA Development Studies, what are the courses are there? Just they will show you the PPT. Later on, individual questions, I will be here. I will clear all the student doubts. There is no problem. And also finally, I tell you, no need to worry about your studies. Regional center responsibility to provide you better student support services. And you can visit our IGNO website, igno.ac.in or mumbai.igno.ac.in, and follow our Facebook page and the Twitter you follow, and you can send. Don't depend much on the phone calls. I'm telling openly, you can send the email to rcmumbai@igno.ac.in. And also every Friday, 11 o'clock, we are having a program. It is called as E-Siksha Ki Baat Regional Director Ke Saath. Speak with your regional director. I'm sitting every Friday, 11 o'clock. That is also through online Google Meet. The link already uploaded in our regional center website. Any grievance, any student, whether you are an IGNO student or the outsider, maybe you are having the any information, any doubt related to the IGNO, you all can join. That link also they're going to show you. That is our responsibility to provide you support services. I wish you all the best. Take care. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much, sir. Dear learners, I think the details, all the details have been provided by our regional director, sir. A lot like about how to write assignments, what points you should take into consideration while writing the assignment, when to submit the assignments, a lot of other details have been provided. Now, as sir told, that few things we will show you on screen, like the website, now like where to find the assignment question papers, how to register for change of address and all other details. One by one, we will take, and maybe we can start with the assignment question paper first. How to find out the assignment question paper. I will share the screen.
Hello. Sir, good morning. Pankaj Kumar here.
Please wait. We will take the student queries.
just now. Even if you type IGNOU assignment in the Google and you click here like web services, this is the direct link which we had given in the PPT as well. This is the link or the page where all the assignment question papers are available for all the students. For master degree, bachelor degree, certificate, diploma, PG diploma, all the learners ke liye, the assignment question papers are available here. The assignment question papers are generally available for means from 2011, 2012 to till date. Now the learners have to see which question paper they have to write. Suppose I take MA history. If you go to MA history, now this question paper is for 2021. Suppose I click here and I download it. The question paper will be downloaded, and in the question paper itself it is written that for which session this question paper is. This question paper is for July 2020 and January 2021. That is, if you are submitting your assignment in the month of April or May 2021 or in the month of September or October 2021, this question paper is going to be valid for you. So this is the question paper you have to solved. And later on there are sets of instructions have been given, few of which have already been explained by sir during his presentation. And apart from that, then you will have question papers, as you all can see over here itself. After that, the next thing will be the website of regional center. That is rcmumbai.ignu.ac.in. So this is the home page of Regional Center Mumbai. At Regional Center Mumbai's website, the learners are supposed to see two tabs most importantly. There are other important details also in the website. It is up to you. Whatever you want to search out, everything is available in the website. Two most important tabs are e-siksha and notice board. Now both of them have been, the link for both of them have been given at the home page only. No need to go to student corner and any other place. Just you can visit any of these, you can click any of these tabs. Suppose I click at notice board. Once I click at notice board, all the important notices like tentative date sheet for December 2020 exams, which is going to be held in February 21. Now there was a promotion policy for the previous learners who could not give their exam due to COVID. Extension for submission of TE December examination form, or extension of say assignment submission dates, online submission of assignments. All these links have been provided in the notice board. The second one is e-siksha. In e-siksha, as sir was telling, that on every Friday at 11 a.m., Regional Center Mumbai organizes a grievance redressal camp with namely e-siksha ki baat regional director ke saath. Now here is the link. Once you click here, any student can join this meeting on Friday at 11 a.m. Every Friday we are organizing. So you have to click here, it will take you directly to the meeting, join the meeting and ask the queries you have. At 11 a.m. every Friday we organize this meeting. Apart from that, social network of RC, YouTube channel, Facebook page and Twitter handle. Now YouTube channel mein all the important videos are being uploaded. Now onwards, the sessions which will be organized will also be recorded. So that might also be available in this YouTube channel itself. Facebook page, you all can follow the Facebook page, those who have the Facebook account, for faster updates as it will come as a notification. Then Twitter handle, we also have Twitter page. The induction meeting presentation slides is available. Whatever presentation have been given is available program wise here. Then induction schedule, and then video. Suppose this video is also being recorded. So these are the recorded sessions of BCom, BA Honours, BA Psychology Honours, and whatever programs ka induction have been conducted. And apart from that, other links like submission ka link, synopsis submission, assignment submission links, all other details have been given in the regional center website itself. So if you are visiting the regional center Mumbai website, you can always visit these two tabs.
Show that the student corner and the study center. You click the study center also, where they get the phone number, email, study center.
Yes, sir. So at the home page only, there are number of tabs on the upward side only. There are number of tabs like student corner and study center. First, we will click the study center. If you click the study center tab, a PDF file will get downloaded. And this is what the PDF file is. We keep on updating it from time to time as there is a, as and when there is any change. In this tab, in this page, you have your study center code, your study center name, the address of the study center, the name of the coordinator or program in charge, who is the in charge of that particular study center, then phone number of the study center, email address of the study center, and working days and times of that particular study center. Now, after COVID, there have been slight change. They are trying to open, few of them are still not open. So this is the standard timing of the study of every study center, what we had collected from the study center and have been uploaded. If there is any change in the timing or anything, it will be updated in this tab, in this page as well. Apart from that, there is student corner. If you click at student corner, there are a number of, in the left hand side, there are a number of details. Now here also, in the left hand side only, in the student corner, as I was telling, that e-siksha, notice board, all those things are available in student corner also. So if you visit the student corner here, you can get the link for e-gyan kosh, date sheet and result, counseling schedule. The counseling schedule will be uploaded here in the student corner. iGram portal is also there, that is a grievance, the whole university. Student support services, question paper, assignment link, all these things you can get directly from student corner itself. So this was about these two things. Now another important thing which again sir was telling is the Samarth portal. Now you also have taken admission in through Samarth portal only, that was ignuadmission.samarth.edu.in. Now onwards, you have to create a new username and password. However, your enrollment number only will be your username. You just have to generate a new password. This is the link, online student support. This is the actual Samarth portal, ignu.samarth.edu.in. Nobody has to use his old username and password. Everybody have to create new password. Now, how to create a new password? You have to click at new registration. Once you click your new registration, it will ask you for program. Choose the program, whichever program you are, write your name as per iCard, write your enrollment number, and then submit. Once you submit, it will ask you for OTP. The OTP will be sent at your registered mobile number and your registered email ID. So you have to put the OTP, you have to generate the password. Once the password is generated, then you have to write your enrollment number as your username. You have to write the password you have just chosen, and then you have to log in. Suppose I log in for, say, one account. Now, how to create the login ID, password, and how to apply for the changes? All those details are also being provided by the has also been recorded. That is, a video has been prepared by the regional center, Mumbai, and in that particular video, we have shown that how should you. How you can register in the portal. After registering, how you can apply for re-registration whenever you are eligible, how you can apply for change of address, change of study center, change of regional center, and many other services which are being provided through that. Now suppose I click at services. Just now, study center change request is here, regional center change request is here, examination form ka direct link, digital source, that is e-gyan kosh ka direct link is here. Even as we were discussing ki assignment ke liye is link pe aise jana hai waise, if you have login at the Samarth portal, you will have the link directly for assignment, not for your particular assignment, but you will get the direct link where you have to go and search for your assignment, previous year question paper, iCard. Even if you have not downloaded your ID card, you can create your username and password at this portal. Now everybody has to create. at some point of time you will have to create, because even if you go for re-registration at this portal only you have to do the re-registration. So at some point of time you will have to create the user the password at this portal, and you'll have to create the login ID at this portal. So many services are there. If you have any issue in creating the password and user ID in this portal, you can always contact us through email as well. This was about how to find out the assignments, previous year question papers, about the regional center website and the Samarth portal. Sir, now maybe we can go for the presentation, small presentations.
Yes, yes. And you can show our YouTube channel. They will you click YouTube channel.
Okay. So just in the e-siksha only, as we were discussing earlier, about our Facebook and Twitter handle, there is a YouTube channel. This is the direct link for our YouTube channel. Once you click this, our YouTube channel will directly get opened for RC Mumbai.
First video they can see, first video, you know, about that creating the user ID and password.
Yes, yes, sir. So this is the first video, online student support activities. This is the video where you can create your user ID and password. So in this induction meeting, all the students who have joined, we request that you all should create your user ID and password and keep it with you. If you have any query while creating the user ID password or after creating, if you have any issue, you can always contact us through email with your registered email ID. So I don't know if voice will come or not, but this is the video. You all can go through this video. The live demo has been given by us, by the regional center. Yes.
Maybe audio aata hai.
Is the audio?
No, here audio ko problem hai. Let them check in their mobiles. You can go for the presentation.
Okay, so this is how you all should go, and you all can visit our website and our YouTube channel for other updates and details. Now there are some small presentations. There are some very small presentations, 4-5 slides presentations for each program which we have prepared. We will share that as well with you. So first we will take Master of Arts in History. Master of Arts in History, basically, as you all are aware, is a 2-year program, maximum duration of 4 years. Earlier it was 5 years. Nobody should get confused for that it is still 5 years. It is 4 years only. Total 64 credits. No need to get much into detail about the credit system. Already there, it was there in the presentation, but focus more that you have to complete the courses for which you are getting registered. आप जितने courses में registration कर रहे हैं, उतने courses का आप complete कर लीजिए, और you will get your degree. This is the first year of MAH, that is history में. First year में you have 4 compulsory courses, that is MHI 1, 2, 4 and 5, all are 8 credit courses. So आपको इन सभी का assignment देना है. All history में all are theory courses only. Assignment submission, examination. Assignment submission, examination. That is what you have to do in MA history. Second year mein, one compulsory course is there. That is MHI 3, historiography. After that, you have 3 more courses which are optional. There are 4 to 5 courses ka list hai. From that, you will have to select 3 optional courses during the re-registration. They also are all theory, assignment and examination. Evaluation, already you all can go through all these details in your program guide also, which is available at open source. Even if you type IGNU MA History program guide, you will get IGNU MA RD program guide, you can get, or IGNU MA DVS program guide, that also you will get. Assignment will be for 30% weightage. It is weightage, not marking system. It is weightage system. that assignment carries 30%, term and exam carries 70%, passing will be at least 40% separately in assignment and term and examination. These activities already sir has informed when you have to do. So for all you have to submit your assignments in the month of April or May. Then examination form again in March, April or May, whenever it is notified. And then re-registration, second year may admission you have to take before completion of your, before giving your first year examination. And then your first year exams will be in June 2021 that you have to appear. Contact details, this is about email ID. You can always contact Regional Center Mumbai at rcmumbai@ignu.ac.in for any type of query. And for other details, like you already, we have uploaded the list of academic counselors for your programs. For every program ka academic counselor ka list, we have uploaded in RC website. That all you can get in the e-siksha tab only. Under e-siksha tab, the list of academic counselors have been uploaded. And this is the email ID of the program coordinator who sits at School of Social Sciences at IGNU New Delhi. And then follow our Facebook page. These are the small details we just wanted to give. In MA history, you do not have any project or practical like that. You only have the assignment submission and term end examination submission. Now we will go for MA Rural Development. The MA Rural Development students have a project work, and as per their registration details, they have already registered for the that project work in the first year itself. So that they have to complete. Apart from that, other things are as similar as MA history students. This also is 2 years and 4 years. Maximum is 4 years, minimum is 2 years. Then first year is all compulsory courses. The fifth one is dissertation, that is project work or dissertation, whatever you can say. Apart from that, four courses are theory for which you have to submit assignment. You have to write the term and examination. But dissertation mein, that is project work mein, you have to prepare the synopsis, submit the final project report. No examination, no assignment. Second year mein, all are optional courses. There are five optional courses which you have to select from the list which will be given you during the re-registration. However, the list I have also typed here. There are total six subjects or courses from which you have to select any five as your optional course. Now, evaluation is same as MA history, so not going into that much detail. However, MRDP 01, that is dissertation, it is compulsory again. First thing is to get a guide. Now, any approved academic counselor of MA Rural Development can become your guide. First thing, how to get the list? The list is already uploaded, as I have informed, under the e-siksha tab. In case the guide is not available, because there are a number of students for MA Rural Development for other programs whom they might be guiding. So in case they are not available for you, you can get your own guide. You can get your own guide from anywhere outside IGNU also you can get. Now, what is the eligibility of the guide? So any person who is assistant professor in any college or university can become your guide. But that assistant professor should be, the discipline of that assistant professor should either be rural development, sociology, anthropology, economics, political science, social work. So koi bhi assistant professor kisi college ka jo in sab subjects ka assistant professor ho, at least assistant professor ho, he or she can become your guide in case you are not getting the guide from IGNU. So synopsis you have to prepare. The synopsis will be approved by your project guide himself. He only will help you to prepare. Finally, he only will approve your proposal. Once the proposal is approved, you can start with your project report. Again, the project work and report is to be done under the guidance of your guide. And finally, you have to submit that project report to SED IGNU New Delhi. There will be number of research work you will be doing, again under the guidance of your guide only. He will be signing number of papers. Or for all those details, all these paperwork and all those details, you all can read the project manual, which will either be given to you in case it is not provided you. It is just, I think, 20-25 pages ka ek book hota hai, jisme sara information you will get. You can search for that material at eGyan Kosh also. Even now also, you can search and you can get all the details for your project manual. Now, activities to be completed, all as same for a Master of Arts in history, so not going that into that much detail again. The contact details, again, email ID of RC Mumbai and the email ID of the program coordinator we have given. The third one is MA Development Studies. MA Development Studies, again, is a new program. I think recently it has been activated under Regional Center Mumbai. This time, So MA Development Studies, almost all everything is same as the other two programs. That is minimum 2 years, maximum 4 years, then the credits, whatever credits. First year mein, all are theory courses, no project, no practical, and all are compulsory. The list of the courses I have already given in the slide. Second year, all are optional courses. Now, there is a project work also, but that also is optional. If you select that project work, then only you have to do it. Otherwise, you can select all theory courses and you can continue with those theory courses, complete and get your degree for MA Development Studies. But the thing is, if you choose that project work, so that project work is for 12 credits. That is, that will be equivalent to two courses. So total, there are six courses in second year. If you choose all theory courses, you will have six theory courses. But if you choose project work as well, that is MDVP 117, then you will have four theory courses and one project work, project report, that will be MDVP 117. For all other details of this project report, because mostly you will have to send the synopsis to headquarters for approval of this. It will be as same as MARD, but the synopsis you have to send to headquarters, that is program coordinator of MADVS at IGNU New Delhi. He will give the approval. And then you can start with your final project work at under the guidance of your guide. The evaluation system is as same as the other two programs. The activities to be completed will also be as same as the other two programs. And the contact details will be as detailed in this slide. The thing is, the most important month for you all will be the month of April. Because in the month of April, you will have to submit your assignments. You'll have to submit your examination form. You'll have to submit your re-registration form. And finally, in the month of June 2021, you'll have to write your examination. Now, Samarth portal pe login is very important because re-registration you will be doing in that portal only. Mostly, maybe this time it will be going to happen or not, we don't know. But however, all will be notified. You have to submit your scanned copy of assignments also. So that also will be available through the link of Samarth also, and outside the Samarth as well, it will be available. Examination form ka link already is available in Samarth portal only. So get logged in into the Samarth portal. For issues, you can always contact to RC Mumbai. And apart from this, I think almost everything we have explained about assignment and study material, as our sir has already informed that we believe that most of you might have received by now, at least few materials you must have received, few might be under dispatch, few of you might not have received any material. So by end of this month, you will receive the material. The important thing is that if you have opted for soft copy of material, then you will not get the hard copy. Do not expect for any email also then I will receive the email copy. You have yourself to go, you yourself have to go to eGyan Kosh ka website or IGNU eContent ka app. There you can get your material if you have opted for soft copy. If the students who have opted for hard copy, they will receive the hard copy of material. If you have not received yet, you also can use the soft copy, which is available at eGyan Kosh and IGNU eContent app. So that is how you all can go through. So we just believe that if you follow the sequence which has been informed to you all during this induction meeting, your journey in IGNU will be quite smooth, we believe. Apart from this, if you'll have any query in future, suppose we will definitely take individual queries, but if you have any query after the completion of induction meeting also, you can always send email to us at rcmumbai@ignu.ac.in. Sir, now maybe we can take the queries.
You can call individual student any queries. They can type their name, enrollment number, and you can call one by one. They can on their video and speak.
Yes, sir. Okay, so just the thing is, whoever has any query should write their name in the chat box. Once you write your name in the chat box, we will call your name. You have to switch on your audio, you have to switch on your video, both, and then you can ask your query. In between, nobody should unmute their mic. We will start. The first name is Nisha Panchal.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, please, Miss Nisha.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
sir, I wanted
please.
To ask where can we find this recording of this session?
What session?
Sir, this meeting.
This meeting we are going to upload in our YouTube channel.
And sir, my enrollment number is lost, and they are asking for the password to open the iCard. So I don't remember the password. So is there a process to reset the password?
I think there is some double voice.
Yes, sir, it is coming twice.
You can mute.
And baad
mein you can on. Whenever speaking, you can on. We have already told you very clearly and also shown that video. Even though if you have forgotten that one password or something, now you have to create new user ID and the password where the services we have shown. You can download your ID card. I think Ms. Nisha, your issue is clear.
Yes, sir. I think she has lost her enrollment number itself. So Nisha, in case you do not have your enrollment number only, you can send email through your registered email ID to RC Mumbai. Okay. Next is Vishal Verma.
Yeah, you are able to hear me? Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
You are able to hear me? Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, quick one. Currently, I'm on a project in Bahrain, and I don't think I will make up in June. So, how to appear the examination?
No, you want to write your exam in the June.
Yes.
Hello. I think maybe in the network room. No, you want to write your exam in the June 2021. Hello. Oh, yeah, Mr. Vishal.
Hello.
Mr. Vishal, we are hearing you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Now you want to write the exam in the June 2021?
Yes, in June.
June 2021, you write your assignment and submit in the month of the April or May. We'll give you the dates as well as the online submission link. We will give you. And you have to fill an examination form.
Your voice is not audible.
May. I think maybe you are having some network problem.
I'm not able to hear.
Sashank, you can type in the chat box.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Whatever he has to do, you type in the chat
box.
I'm
not
box.
Able to hear anything.
Mr. Vishal, you are typing in the chat box. You can see it. And meanwhile, you can call other person, other student.
Hello. Friend, I'm not
Sashang,
able to hear anything.
Sashang, in code, but you can type the reply here.
Hello.
Hello.
हाँ सर, हाँ फ्रेंड, I'm not able to hear sir's voice. Can you?
No, you no. If you want hello, to appear hello. Your examinations in June 2021, so you will have to fill the examination form in April. Now you are telling that you are outside India. So when will you be coming back? You'll be here in June.
See, I'm on and off basically. I'm on a project for a year now.
Okay.
Almost here.
Okay.
So, I think here also at Indian Embassy that examination is going on.
Two things I will tell.
Yeah.
First is, see, the tentative schedule will be available. The tentative schedule will be available at least one and a half month prior to the examination. You can plan accordingly if possible for
the month
of June. In case you are not able to appear for June examination, you can automatically appear for the December examination, December 2021. Uh-huh. For that, you'll have to fill your examination form in the month of October, September or October 2021, and appear your examinations in December 21.
Okay.
Second thing, telling about that international examination center. See, IGNU has international examination center as well as study centers,
uh-huh.
but the exact details are not aware mm-hmm. exactly in which countries. They are in the Middle East nations only. But for that, you'll have to contact the international division. IGNU has international division.
Uh-huh. You are in, Mr. Vishal, you are in which country?
Okay.
You are in which country? Huh?
Bahrain.
There is, but anyhow, that is for now. That exam
Bahrain.
Only the international
Bahrain.
Students. You are an Indian. You cannot write the exam there. You have to write it only in India.
Okay. So I will contact the local center in that.
No. You send a mail to international division at igba.ac.in. Hello.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Fair enough. I will send the email to you.
Okay. Next is.
And more. One more thing. Like assignment. Assignment. Can I send to you or by email? By courier to your office.
See most.
RC Mumbai.
Most probably the assignments will have to be submitted in soft copy. That is, you have to write it. It should be handwritten, but you can scan it and you have to upload. So you can upload it from any place. In case it is offline. That that is very less. Mostly it will be online only. If it is offline, you can send it by post.
Okay. Done. Thank you, my friend.
Okay. Mm-hmm. The next student will be, Shlok Shinde. M-A-R-D. Shlok Shinde.
Yes, sir. May I?
You can ask.
Okay, so the question that I had is, in the assignment column that you had mentioned, so the MARD's assignment have not been updated yet. So may I please know by what time will that be uploaded or updated?
I will just check because most of the program, there are few programs definitely, jinka assignment have not been uploaded. That will be uploaded by end of this month if it has not been uploaded yet. But let me just check it once if it has not been uploaded.
Okay.
Yeah, it has not been uploaded for you. So it will be uploaded by end of this month.
Okay, sure. And the submission has to be done by the month of March or April, right?
April. Mostly it will start in April.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Okay. Next is Mannat More.
Hello, sir. Actually, sir, I am currently pursuing LLB from Mumbai University Government Law College, and I am in my third year. It would conclude this academic year, that is June 2021. So now, as I have also pursued my MA in rural development, the clash in academics year bother me some future because I also plan to do a PhD.
See, the thing is, as of now, the UGC has not allowed two degrees simultaneously. It means there were some news, but no notification has been found, at least by us, in the website. What you can do, if there's any doubt, you can just postpone your examination, your degree, by 6 months. So instead of writing your examination in June 2021, you can write your first year exams in December 21. So in that way, it will not create any problem.
Sir, so my academic year would be, how that would be, what year it will be calculated? Like 21, 22 or 20, 21 only? Like if I postpone my exam?
In the mark sheet or in the degree certificate, academic year is never mentioned. In the degree, IGNU ka mark sheet and degree certificate, the only thing in the degree certificate will be written that when did you complete your program. Suppose if you have completed your program in December 2022, so they will write so and so person has passed so and so degree with so and so division in December 2022. Like that, it will be here written.
And sir, so similarly, if I have to attempt it in December, then the assignment and the project work which we have to do, we'll have to complete it by May end itself, or the dates would be different for December?
It will be different. You can submit it in October, September and October.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Next is Garima Sachdev. Garima Sachdev. Okay, next is Pooja Jaiswal. Pooja Jaiswal. Then Navneet Kumar.
Now, if the students are not having any queries and issues, they can leave
Hello,
the
sir.
Meeting. No need to.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Hello sir, good afternoon.
Can I hear you? Bolye.
Sir, I have a small query regarding assignment writing. For assignment, I should use a single sided page or double sided page. Which one is better for that?
See, I think during the presentation, our regional director sir has already informed these things. You can use any type of paper you want.
Okay.
Just the thing. It should not be color paper.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
This is up to you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Next is Shobhit Srivastav.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon. Actually, I have a small query that if I want to attempt 3 exams in July, maybe in June, and maybe 3 in December, so I can give assignments for the 3 in April and 3 maybe in October or November. Will that be okay?
Yes.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Then next is Chaturbhuj Singh.
Oh, how many exams do we have to write?
No, how many courses you have, for that many courses you have to write the exams.
Okay, thank you.
Next is Vasudha Deshmukh. Vasudha Deshmukh.
Hello.
हाँ बोल, पूछिए.
सर मुझे ये पूछना था कि मेरा जो नाम है वसुधा देशमुख, तो मेरे मैरिज के पहले का जो वसुधा जोगरेकर करके नाम था वो एनरोल हुआ है, तो वो कैसे बदलने का, चेंज करना है मुझे. मेरा वसुधा जोगरेकर प्री मैरिज नेम है.
ठीक है, तो आपको उसी टाइम डालना चाहिए था आपका मैरिज के बाद वाला नाम वैसे.
हाँ, तो वैसे वो क्या हुआ कि जो फादर्स नेम है वहां पे मेरा हस्बैंड नाम गया है, और जो मेरा नाम है वसुधा माधव जोगरेकर आया है, जो मेरे मैरिज पहले का नाम था. और वसुधा गिरी
आपका मैरिज सर्टिफिकेट और गैजेट नोटिफिकेशन है आपके पास?
मैरिज सर्टिफिकेट है सर.
और गैजेट?
गैजेट नहीं है।
अच्छा ठीक है, आप एक काम करिए, आप आरसी मुंबई को ईमेल कर दीजिए वो मैरिज सर्टिफिकेट के साथ, तो वो एक बार चेक करके हम आपको बता देंगे क्या क्या चाहिए रहेगा और नेम चेंज के लिए।
अच्छा तो मेल करने से होगा?
नहीं, मेल करने से नहीं होगा, नेम चेंज देखना पड़ता है, उसका फीस भी लगता है 500 रुपीज, उसका अलग चार्ज रहता है। तो वो पहले अच्छा। आपके डॉक्यूमेंट चेक कर लेंगे हम, और
क्योंकि मेरे सारे सर्टिफिकेट्स वसुधा देशमुख है मतलब बाद में, और पहले सारे जो ग्रेजुएशन के जो सर्टिफिकेट है वो सारे मेरे वसुधा जोगेकर करके है, लेकिन जो मेरे दूसरे मास्टर्स किए हैं मैंने मास्टर्स इन आर्कियोलॉजी तो वो सारे वसुधा देशमुख करके है।
आप वो मैरिज सर्टिफिकेट और जो भी डॉक्यूमेंट्स आपके हैं आप बता रही हैं वो सब हमको ईमेल कर दीजिए, तो एक बार चेक करके हमें बताना पड़ेगा कि क्या प्रोसेस से आपका नेम चेंज होगा।
अच्छा तो मेल किस पे करूं मैं?
मेल आईडी आरसी मुंबई की है, मैं वैसे लिख भी दे रहा हूं इसमें।
अच्छा आप यहां पे देंगे क्या मेल
आईडी? चैट बॉक्स मैंने लिख दिया है वो, उस पे आप कर लीजिए। आरसी
मुंबई, अच्छा इस पे मैं मेल करके मेरा क्वेरी बोल दूं कि ऐसे ऐसे क्वेरी है। थैंक यू सर।
उसके बाद नेक्स्ट विल बी हाँ विशाल वर्मा जी, यू हैव एनरोल्ड फॉर अ डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम पीजी डिप्लोमा, सो फॉर दैट प्रोग्राम अगेन इंडक्शन मीटिंग विल बी कंडक्टेड। नाउ व्हाटएवर रीजनल सेंटर यू हैव चूज़न, दैट रीजनल सेंटर विल कंडक्ट दैट इंडक्शन मीटिंग अगेन और माइट हैव कंडक्टेड एज ऑफ नाउ। इफ इट इज आरसी मुंबई, वी हैड ऑलरेडी कंडक्टेड फॉर पीजी डिप्लोमा स्टूडेंट्स, वन मोर इंडक्शन मीटिंग इज शेड्यूल्ड, इफ यू हैव नॉट बीन कॉल्ड अगेन यू विल बी कॉल्ड दिस टाइम। ओके so with this sir all the queries have been done, there is no name in the chat box now,
there is no issues at the queries, the students can make use of the facility of the Friday meeting if you are having any queries, and other in the Friday meetings our staff also all will present, and all the section people they will clear your doubts on spot, and you can send the email to rcmumbai@igno.ac.in. Finally I wish you all the best for your studies, our staff all the time cooperative, and they will also answer all your queries on the particular Friday or other even through emails also. I wish you all the best, thank you one and all. Shashank, you can close.
Yes sir. So thank you very much learners, so this induction meeting has been done. Now in every induction meeting, as our regional director sir informs us all, that this is just the beginning of your journey in IGNU, and we wish a best of luck to you all, and in any case if you have any query, you all can always send email to rcmumbai@ignu.ac.in, or you can log in through that e-shiksha ki baat regional director ke saath. Regional center here is here to support you all. With this we are closing the induction meeting now. Thank you.